Hey guys, welcome to my channel, iCode. I am Pallav and today we are going to look at server-side programming in Swift. I have seen many iOS developers or mobile developers in general, they try to learn backend development, server-side programming, writing web services, and for this, they start learning Node.js, Go, Spring Boot, new languages, new frameworks, and while doing so, they struggle a lot. And there's no point of learning something which can be already done by a language that you are already comfortable with. And there are a lot of benefits of using something that you already know. Let's say you are a freelancer, now you don't need a backend guy. Or even if you are not, but you want to implement some cool idea that requires a backend, you don't need someone who knows backend. You can build it on your own. So today in this video, we will see that how we can use Swift at server side. And for doing so, we will make a dummy application for flights booking. It will have two APIs, one for fetching the list of the flights and one for getting the detail of a selected flight. Let's see how it will look like. We will be having two APIs, first for fetching the list of flights, and this is how it will look like. So this is how we'll get the data for showing the list of flights, and through this data we can render a screen something like this. So this list is being rendered by this data. And second will be for fetching the details of a specific flight, so we'll be passing the code of the flight here, and this is how the data we'll get. So the baggage information, the duration of the flight, whether the cancellation is available or not, and everything else, the details we'll get from this API. And with this, we can render a screen something like this. And apart from building these two APIs, we'll also see that how can we render a web page at server side. So rendering a web page at server side means the HTML is being prepared at the server side. So server is making calls to the database, fetching the data, applying the business logic, doing the heavy computations. And finally, after doing all that, server prepares a HTML and returns it back to the client, that is our browser, and browser displays it. So for that, we are having this web page, this HTML page, which we will be rendering at server side, or should I say that the HTML for this page will be returned from our server. We'll see that how can we do that. So this is all what we will be doing in this video. Let's see that how we'll do it. We will use Perfect for all the heavy lifting. So for example, creation of the HTTP server, routing, all these jobs will be done by Perfect. Perfect is a toolkit that is written in Swift, and using Perfect, we can create the HTTP servers, we can handle the routing, we can connect to the databases like Mongo, Maria, MySQL. We can extend our servers to the messaging queues like Kafka, Zookeeper, Mosquito, etc. We can even use Perfect for deploying our application directly to the AWS EC2 instance using the Perfect Assistant. But in this video, we will use Perfect only for two things, that is creation of the HTTP server and handling the routes. But if you want to know more about the Perfect, this is the official site of Perfect. You can go there and you can see that what all Perfect is capable of and how can you use it. You can also look at the documentation, and they guys have documented their APIs in a very understandable manner. So this is how it looks like. Now let's get started. So the first thing that we need for using Swift for server-side programming is Swift toolchain. So if you are an iOS developer or you are having Xcode installed in your machine, then Swift toolchain is automatically installed. But if you are not, then you need to install Swift toolchain, and for that you can visit this page of getting started, and it will tell you that how can you install the Swift toolchain from swift.org. So I'm assuming that you are having Xcode or you are having the Swift toolchain installed. So let's start the work. The first thing that we need is a directory for our project. So go to terminal and create a directory. Navigate to this directory. Now we'll use Swift Package Manager for initializing the project. And at this point in time, we are having our project initialized from Swift Package Manager. Now, the next thing that we need to do is add Perfect as the dependency. But before doing that, let's create the Xcode project, because we'll be using Xcode as our ID and we'll be doing everything else in the Xcode only. So this will create the Xcode project for you, and now we can open our project in the Xcode. So here we have a file that is package.swift, And in the dependencies array of this package description, we will put our dependency for the perfect modules. So for that, I'll put the GitHub repo link of the perfect modules here in the specific format. And you do not worry about these code or these lines or whatever I'm doing. I'll host the entire project on the GitHub. You can clone it from there. Also, I'll put these specific stuff in the description as well, so you can copy it from there. Now that we have mentioned our dependency on perfect in our package description, go to the terminal and hit the command swift build. This will fetch the dependencies from the Git. We see that the perfect modules have been fetched from Git, but we are getting a warning here that its perfect HTTP server is not used by any target. And that is because we have not added our dependency, or we have not added perfect to any target. So for that, let's go back to the Xcode, and here in the executable target dependencies, let's mention perfect. Now once again, we'll run swift build and we'll create our Xcode project once again. I'll run the command for generating the Xcode project once again so that all these dependencies are linked properly. And now the Xcode is saying that the project has been changed outside the Xcode, so whether or not we want to accept the Xcode version or the disk version, and I'll go for use the version on the disk because I know that I have updated the project from the terminal. So now that we have the perfect dependencies installed, we have added it to the target. Let's go to the main.swift where we have this hello world. And before giving it a run, make sure that you select the flight booking app package here, and the device should be your Mac. So I'll select my Mac, the Rosetta version here, and now I'll try to run it. I see hello world in the console. So it means that it ran successfully and nothing is breaking. Now let's start our work, and instead of this print hello world, let's import our perfect dependencies here. So perfect lib, we'll need perfect HTTP, and we'll need import perfect HTTP server. The first thing that we want to do is we want to create our HTTP server. So for that, let's assign a port to the server. And let's start it. Let's try running it. And in the logs, we see that starting HTTP server on 0.0.0:8080. 8080 is the port that we have assigned to our server. So our server will be listening at the port 8080. And this means that we have created our HTTP server successfully. Now let's add some routes to it. And routes are basically the URIs which the client will be using for requesting something. But before that, let's create our directory structure because that is the OCD that I have. So I'll create three directories. One will be for data, where the dummy data, the dump, will be there. The second will be for the controllers. The controllers will have all the business logic. We are not having much for this dummy application, but in the actual application, your controllers will have your business logic. And in the routes directory, you will have your routers. For this dummy application, we will be having only one router, but in an actual project, you can have several routers for routing to V1, V2, different versions of your application. Let's create the directories. Now in the controllers, let's create two files, one for the flight listing and one for the flight's detail. These will be the Swift files. And make sure you select your application here as the target and remove this OpenSSL. Otherwise, it will create the cyclic references and will throw the errors. Let's create one more file for the details. I'm creating one file here in the data directory as dummy data. And first of all, in this dummy data, I'll just dump some data here. And either you can go for creating your own structure, your own JSON, or your own dictionary structure, or you can copy this data directly from the GitHub repo that I'll be mentioning in the description. So this is the dummy data that we'll be using for the flights list and this is for the flight's details data. If you want, you can use the same data for both the routes, that is listing and the detail. But here I want to return more data for the details route, so that is why I am having this second set of data, that is in this method get flight details data. Now that we have our dummy data ready, let's go to the controllers and let's add the logic for returning the data. So here I have added a class that is flight list controller and added a method that is handle flight list request. It will receive two parameters. One will be for the HTTP request and the other one will be for the HTTP response. We'll use the response object for returning the data. So we'll call the method set body on the response object. And as the JSON, we will pass the flight list data. So this is the method that we created in our dummy data. This is the get flight list. So this will return this data. And after setting it to the body, I'm setting the headers as the application JSON and completing it with OK status. But if something goes wrong, then in the catch block, I'm treating it as internal server error and returning it on the completed block as the internal server error. And all these things, I haven't created any enum or anything else for this internal server error or OK. All these things are available out of the box from the perfect package. So instead of internal server error, if you hit control space here, you will see that you have all the options for bad request, bad gateway, accepted, conflict. And you are free to choose the option as per your logic, the way you want to handle the request. So for now, I am handling it as internal server error in the catch block and in the success block. If everything goes well, I'm returning it as status OK. That will be 200. Now let's add a similar method for fetching the flight details. So here in the flight's detail controller, similar to the flight list controller, I created a class that is flight's detail controller and added a method that is handle flight's detail request. Similar to that method, here also I'm getting two objects for request and response. But here I'm doing something different, and that is I'm fetching the ID from the request. So you can assume that the request will be something like this slash details, that will be a route. And that will be followed by some ID of the flight, that is 1001, 1002, or any other number. And I want to fetch this particular number, this particular ID for fetching the details from the details data. And for that, I'm using the URL variables property of the request object and querying for my key, that is ID in this case. So if I get the ID, I'll use the flight's detail data, I'll filter it for that particular ID and will return the response. Otherwise, I'm treating it as a bad request that the ID is missing and I'm returning it as the bad request. Rest looks the same as the flight list method. So in the similar way, I'm setting the body here with the flight details as the JSON, the headers as application JSON and completing it with the OK status. If something goes wrong in this entire do part, then it is some internal server error, something went wrong. So we are done with our controller logics. We are done with creating the server. The only part missing is connecting the routes. And for that, let's go in this routes directory and create a file. Let's create a router. I'll name it router. In this router, I'll create a method that is setup router. Which will return the routes object. So for that, I need to import the perfect package first. Import perfect lib. And now I can return the routes object from here. Now let's first create the routes object and add some routes to it. And here I'll use this one where I can get the method, the HTTP method. For now, I want to put it as get. You can change it to post as well. The URI will be say slash flights for the listing. And in the request handler, we'll have a closure having request and response. And what I'll do is, I'll call the get flight list data and will pass the request and response object to it. Flight list controller handle flight list request, request and response. Let's add one more route. For our details method, this will also be get. And here with details, I'll mention id in the braces, because this will be a variable that we'll be fetching from the request. And flights detail controller, and in flights detail request, yes, response. And now let's return the routes. So now our router is also set up. The last piece of code that is remaining is adding these routes to our server. So in the main.swift server.addRoutes, and here I'll call my method setUpRouter. Everything seems fine. Let's try running our server, and here we'll get an error. I'll explain it to you in a minute. We got the error that address already in use, and this is because the port on which we want to start our server is already busy from our previous run. So in case you get this error, what we can do is we can kill the process that is using that port, and for that go to the terminal, use the list of files command, so lsof, and mention our TCP port, that is 8080 in our case. We'll get the PID here and then just kill that particular process using its PID, that is 31667 in this case. And now if I see, there's no process running on port 8080. So now if we'll try running our application, it will. Cool. So everything is in place. Server has started. Let's test our routes. For that, I'll be using Postman as the client. And here, instead of 3000, I'll use 8080 slash flight, that is our route. And we are getting the response. Let's try changing it. Or maybe let's first try the second route. So it goes like 8080 slash details slash, and let's not mention the ID because we have handled the case where the ID will not be passed and we'll be returning the bad request that ID is missing. And that is what we got here. Bad request 400. Now let's pass some ID, and the IDs we are getting in our first call, that is 1002, 1001 maybe. So let's go for this Vistara one, 1002. And we got the data. I'm using the same web services in the iOS application that I showed earlier. So I'll be pushing the code for that too on the GitHub repo. You can clone it from there. It is pretty much straightforward stuff over there. I have used Swift UI for building the UI. Combine and URL session for fetching the data, and combine for the interaction between the view model and the views. It's pretty much straightforward. Let's not buy time on it. And now let's see that how can we render a web page that I talked about. So let's go for it. In the router, let's create one more route on which we'll be returning the HTML, routes.add. The method will be get, and let's leave the URI as slash. This means that we'll get the response for this particular route on localhost colon 8080 slash, that's all. And in the handler, we'll get request, and my bad, request and response. And instead of adding another controller, let's return the HTML data from the dummy data itself. So in the dummy data, I need the HTML data over here. So that's the HTML code for our web page. Let's call this method here from our router. And here, instead of returning it as a JSON, I'll be returning it as a string, because that's what the client, our browser, is expecting. So here on the response, I'll be calling the method setBody. And I'll pass the string that is getIndexData. Let's call the completed. Let's run it again and test our web page. Here in the browser, let's try localhost 8080 is our port. And this is the web page, this is the HTML data that we have written from our server. So this way we can render the web pages at the server side. And by now you would have got an idea that what we can do using Swift at server side. Almost everything is possible. I haven't encountered anything yet that is not possible using Swift at the server side. Perfect gives a lot of features and we can use them out of the box. So here you can see that if I go for Perfect Assistant, you will see that we can use it for deploying our application directly to the AWS EC2 instance. We can use it for testing our application on the fly. We can extend it to the messaging queues. And the more you will deep dive in, more you will get to know. So that's pretty much for this video. Let's break the stereotype that Swift can be only used for building iOS applications or can be used only for Apple platform. Swift.org is trying hard to make it platform independent, and let's start using it for the other stuff like building the backend, server-side programming. Let's write better code together. Happy coding and stay safe.